We are joined in Abyssinia Baptist Church, Pastor Raleigh McCormick, service in progress.
I can be lost. Okay. I'm going to be lost, but I'm still in Christ Jesus. See, when you feel sometimes you want to do something and God's got something else for you to do, you kind of get in that state, and you got to wait on Him to tell you what to do, because what I want to do is different than what He wants me to do, and we have to learn that sometimes. Oh, it's strange. You lost? How can you be lost in Christ? Yes, I better be lost in Christ. That means that's the only thing around me is Christ. The only thing that I'm concerned about is the Word that's around me, not the world that's around me, but the Word that's around me. That's what's important. And how you want me to deliver your Word today. So when I say I'm lost in Christ. I'm in the best place in the world to be lost in, because I'm lost in Him. I know without a shadow of a doubt that when I'm walking through a situation, He is there with me. I know He will make me lie down in green pastures. I know I ain't nobody I should be afraid of. And He said, watch and see what happens to those that mess with His chosen people. So I'm I'm right where He wants me to be. You might not want me to be there, but I'm right where He wants me to be, and everybody in here is where He wants them to be right now. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Sometimes you just gotta hum. Because I can't say much. All I can do is hum and say thank you. That's the key word, assurance today, and a thank you today. I'm assured without a shadow of doubt that I'm a child of the King. I'm surely sure that He is going to take care of me. I am surely sure that even though my foot might stumble, there's going to be an angel out there that's going to keep me from falling. I just feel like going through a couple songs. That's what I just feel like doing, because they have helped me and guided me. First song. When you get there, say amen.
Amen.
But quietness. All right. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him I will trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and the noisome of pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings thou shalt trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. Neither shall no evil fall thee, befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For He shall give His angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against the stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder, the young lion and the dragon thou shalt trample under feet. Because He has set His love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high because he has known my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and shew him my salvation. Give the Lord a hand clap this morning. Thank you for the reading of the word. Thank you, Father. I need you right now in the name of Jesus to speak into your people this morning. Lord, I can't do it by myself. I don't want to do it by myself. I need you this morning. I need you to overtake my thoughts, my ideas, my mind, anything to do with me. I want you to take it over right now. In the name of Jesus, speak unto your people. Amen. 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 What did we say our word was for today?
Assurance.
Assurance. Okay. My assurance. That's what we're going to title this. I didn't have this. This is not what I call myself getting ready to talk about. But it just is what it is. This happens to be one of your pastor's favorite scriptures. There are three of them. Psalms 23, Psalm 27, and Psalms 91. That is the word and the anchor in which I preside and provide and are provided for in believing that God is always going to take care of me. But my assurance is hung right here. So we're going to talk about how we can be assured. my assurance should be your assurance, but all of our assurance should be in Christ Jesus. Now, what is assurance? How do we get assurance? First of all, we have to understand where it comes from. We got to understand who's providing it and understand what it does. So what did I say right then? Y'all talk. The first thing was where it comes from, right? Number one.
What it is,
where it comes from,
and who provides it.
Okay, what is assurance? And how does that work here? He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High, and I'm going to walk it down like this, because he that dwelleth in the secret place would be us. He, meaning plural, anybody that believes in Christ Jesus would be he. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High under the shadow of the Almighty. So, okay, what is it? It's a comfort. Assurance is a comfort. It is a belief that something is going to be provided regardless of what's going to happen. Let's put it like this. When you worked or you work, you believe that you're going to get a check at the end of the week because you went into the job. You have an assurance that as long as I work, I'm going to get paid. We believe that more than we believe in the Word of God. We believe in where we went to work more than we believe, unfortunately, in the Word of God. Because if you pay attention, if they believed in the Word of God more, they do more of what He said and less of what they want to do. But they're not actually assured that God is going to come through and provide, because we're always looking for it when we want it. Mm-hmm. But what it is, what an assurance is belief that no matter, I will say in the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him I will trust. It's trust. Do you trust what it is simply basic trust. Do you trust in the Word of God? Or are you shaky about the Word of God? I can't answer that for you. I can answer it for me, but we all need to do a self-check before we can say, oh, I'm assured. I'm assured that I'm a child of the King. No, y'all ain't. No, you ain't. Because if you was assured of the child of the King, you wouldn't have to defend yourself all the time. You wouldn't have to fight back all the time. Because we do that. On our jobs, in our houses, out in the street. We do a lot of fighting back. But if I'm assured, all I really got to do is believe that if I make a humble suggestion, that God will take care of the rest. I.e., I bought a pair of pants and they don't have a bring back thing. It says final. It's final. But I believe anything is possible in Christ. So the belief is in doing the work. Faith without works is dead. A lot of us say we got faith and we won't do the work. We won't get up. We won't even try. Because sometimes we're not assured that the outcome will be what we wanted. What is it? My assurance comes from my trust in God. Does your assurance come from your trust in God? And who is God? Is He the Almighty, or is He just somebody I go to once in a while? And do you, what did it say right here? I will say to the Lord, He is my refuge. It ain't my paycheck. It ain't Home Depot. It ain't my wife, love her dearly. It ain't my mother, my brothers, or my sisters. It's Jesus. It's God. It ain't what I do to make sure somebody like me, because I can do all that I wanted to and they can still not like me. I can give them everything they wanted and they still wouldn't like me. But if I give my love to Christ Jesus and I honor him and obey him and stay under his shadow, I'm going to be all right. That's an assurance. Because I'm not even assured of waking up tomorrow, but one thing I am assured of, if I don't wake up, I'm going to be with Jesus. That's a heck of assurance. If you allow me to wake up, I'm going to be all right. And if you don't allow me to be all right, wake up, I'm going to be all right anyway, because I'm going to be with him. I ain't going to have no more pain, no more worry, no more bills, no more arguing, no more nothing. So it's a win if you allow me to stay here because you're going to keep me, and it's a win if you decide to take me away, and it's a win as long as I'm obedient to what you want me to do. Because of where the stuff comes from. He said, he shall cover me. I'm surely, surely, I wrote some work. Surely, surely. Surely, 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 he shall deliver you from what? Does it say? The snare of the fowler, from that little sneaky thing that came up on you that tried to trick you. That old situation, that old fear that I had, that old, they're going to use me if I let go sometime. He says, I will deliver you from the snare of the fowler. Why? I'm assured right here because he says it in two or three different ways. What are you going to do for us? Not just me, it's you too. He said, and from the noosome of pestilence. What is pestilence? Pestilence is sickness. Pestilence is stuff that people carry and it spreads and then it gets everybody infected and it's just a pain in the rear end. But he said, I will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the noosome, the worrying of the pestilence around you. I don't have to worry about Donald Trump. He's a pestilence. I don't have to worry about the government, because there can be a pestilence. I don't have to worry about the people that don't like me and who I am, because I know whose I am and I know what shadow I'm under. Can I get a witness? Surely. Surely. Then he says, he gonna cover me. Just in case I'm parked in the middle of the pestilence somewhere and it ain't time for me to go nowhere, he says, I'm going to cover you. I'm going to cover you. God is going to cover you. You are covered. No matter what they're going to do, what people say, what the world tries to give you, you are a covered individual under the shadow of the Almighty. What kind of assurance did I got? It is raining, atomic rain. It's radioactive rain out here, but God says, I'm going to cover you that it don't mess me up. With whose feathers? I'm being honest. That's why that picture right there is so important to me. I remember it in time of trouble. It's like an eagle's wing. When the eagle's wings, when his baby is under his wings, can't nothing get him. Nothing. Can't nothing get you. If you are assured of being under the wings of Jesus Christ, you ain't got to worry about it. It can't do nothing to you. It can't harm you. It can strengthen you. It can give you more courage. It can help you extend the faith which you say you have. Because if you don't have a trial, you don't have a test. If you don't have a test, you don't have a testimony. If you don't have a testimony, you can't be assured about nothing. Can you think about the last time God brought you through something that you didn't think you was going to get out of? Or you even put yourself in that position
God didn't put you in that position, but he got you out of that position anyway. He said he'll cover thee with his feathers and under his wings. What did he say? Thou shalt trust. Comes back to, do you trust him? Do you really trust him? All the time. Not sometime. Not just the day because you got everything you wanted. The time to check out the trust in the Lord is when ain't nothing going right. When I ain't got no gas and I ain't got no money.
Amen.
And I gotta go somewhere. And I really believe that I gotta get there. Oh, you know what? I found $50 bill in my pocket because I cleaned my pockets out. Didn't know it. I had the money.
All right.
Oh, it happened to me, I know. Because I trust in him that if I go digging a little bit, he done made it so I done forgot sometime. And my answer has been right there. My ram in the bush is right there.
Right.
He says, thou shall not be what? Y'all don't got it. You don't got it. He said, I shall not be afraid. We walk around here in fearful. Why you walk around here but your past life? My past was a mess. I talk about me when it comes to that, and I always say that every week, but it is what it is. But in my past, didn't God, in spite of my past, God still keep on blessing me. In spite of my old ways, God gave me some new ways. In spite of my old name, I actually got a new name. Abraham's name was changed from Abram to Abraham. He got a new name because he's a new person.
All right,
you got a new name because you're a new person if you're assured that Jesus Christ is Lord of your life.
All right, now.
The Raleigh then is different than the Raleigh now. I got a new name. Raleigh means something different now than it used to mean then. When people see Raleigh coming, they don't start turning the other way or locking their pockets. When they see Raleigh coming now, they just don't believe that he's still the new Raleigh.
All right.
Oh, do they still believe you the new you? Or are they waiting on a flashback? Matter of fact, do you believe that you still the new you? Because you tend to flashback. It ain't their fault, it's your fault. You tend not to believe that God has decided to bless you in spite of yourself. Mm-hmm. He said, no, I shouldn't be afraid for the terror by night. Terror by night, I should be assured that even though it's dark, it's a light in his tongue. Even though I can't see nothing, God's got my hand. He gonna hold on to me and he ain't gonna let me go. I'm assured that he is never gonna let me go. I got that deep down in my soul. Do you got it deep down in your soul that he is never gonna let you go?
Amen.
We just sung the song. Hold my hand, Lord. Hold my hand. Keep me, Lord. Guide me. Lead me on. But you want to let go. It got too tough. This tunnel is too long. But he said, yea, though I walk through the valley in the shadow of death, that's a tough place to be in. He said, thou shalt be with me. Are you assured of it? Yeah, they put me in jail for something I didn't really do. I had to trust him that I'm going to get out of here, but I had to hold on for peace because couldn't nobody find me. They couldn't find me. They tried to hide me, but God revealed it. And then they had to apologize because they did it for the wrong reason, for the wrong thing. That's that pestilence. That's that nuisance.
stuff that's going on. The world will trick you if you're not assured of who and whose you are. He says, 1,000 shall fall where? And 10,000 at thy right hand. Now, where two or more gathered, they can set 10,000 to flight. That's what the Bible says. So if you got a wife and you got a husband, better hold on to them, because y'all can put most stuff down that one can by himself. But God says you don't need to be afraid of anything, because he has let you see what happened to the wicked. Have you turned around and took a look at some of those people that try to take advantage of you sometime? Have you looked at their life? They had it all going on, but they ain't got it going on no more. They might not even be here right now. They had all the money in the world. They misused me and used me, but they ain't got nothing coming. Because God said, vengeance is mine, thus saith the Lord. I don't have to be jealous. I got to be thankful that, Lord, you changed me. Lord, you turned me around. Matter of fact, Lord, you took me through that dark valley so I would open my eyes, because I couldn't see in the light of day. So I had to go in nighttime to get some vision. He had to make it dark for us sometime to bring us to the light. Because in the dark day sometime, his light shines brightest. Y'all don't know what I'm talking about. You don't know what assurance in him is. Because if I'm assured, okay, I'm going to have a quiet moment. I got to get down on my knees because I have not been praying. I have not been with him like I should be. But once I break down and get down on my knee, I know he's going to hear me anyway. Lord, I ain't been talking to you much, but you know I need you. I've been doing all the stuff that I shouldn't be doing, thinking the stuff I shouldn't be thinking, but Lord, I know you'll forgive me. Forgive me of my sins and my trespasses. Lead me and guide me. Show me the way. I'm assured that he's going to show me. I'm assured that he's going to make the night day and make the day night. I'm assured that he's going to get me through this tunnel of my life, through this season of my life, because he promised me that he shall not let me fall. He shall not let me be consumed. He promised me. I'm assured in the fact of where he is, and I'm assured most definitely that he has never broken a promise. He has never broken a promise. He said, only with thine eyes, your eyes, he will show you. Just pay your tithes. He'll show you what you can do with what's left. You can keep yours, or you can take his. I'd rather have his than to have mine. Because his multiplies. He's got the best interest that anybody can get. We can't get that much interest on our own. But if we trust in him, that's some kind of assurance. I can tell you right now, 80% of the people that come to church will never pay 10% of their money to the church, because they got the wrong idea. The idea is not being provided for the church. The idea is believing in God that you promised me that my labor would not go in vain. And I'm assured that my work will not go in vain. Since I'm assured of it, I'm going to give you what you asked me for. Might even give you a little bit more, because I won't be overly insured. Because you said you would pour out the windows that I could not receive it. Okay, I had cancer twice and I'm still well. I'm still walking and I'm still talking. I'm still seeing people. I'm still helping people. I can still say, I didn't make it on my own. This ain't my own time. This is his time. Because on my own, I wouldn't have had the time. But he said he wouldn't let no pestilence come into my house and take me away. I'm assured of that right now. Oh, excuse me. Because he has made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High. He repeats it. Habitation. Where do I live? Where do you live? I don't live at 10357 Broadmead. I live in Christ Jesus. Mm-hmm. That's just the place he resided for us to keep us. But I better stay in, be in, always live in Christ Jesus. I got to be habitated by the Word of God. Because the Word of God is going to fix me when I don't want to fix myself. Because it's like, what did he say? It's like marrow to my bones. I can't keep on doing this because my body won't act right. My mind just won't be right. I can't sleep right. Because I'm assured that I'm his, he gonna fix me when I don't think I need fixing. Or when I know I need fixing, he gonna fix me anyway. I am assured without a shadow of a doubt that God is my master and my savior. In him I do trust. I don't trust myself, but I trust him. Do you trust him? Do you trust him? He says, we got some help. We got some help. He said, I'll send my angel. What they gonna do? What the angels gonna do? He shall give his angels charge over you. Now you better be careful, because you don't know if you entertained an angel or not. You don't know who God gonna use as an angel in your life to try and get you fixed, to try and nudge you into the right path. Or try and get you to be out of that fear that you just constantly walk in. Because we are a workmanship in Christ. He sent those angels, because if he didn't send us those angels, we would fall. We would fall flat down on our face. He says he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all. He didn't say some of your ways. Them little backwater ways that you got that you think don't nobody see. Them ways. All right. The ways that keep you in fear or keep you comfortable, because your fear never shows, because you're always going to do something to hide the fear in which you do have. Oh, just like driving by the police. Drive by the police and you got suspended license, your nerve gonna act crazy every time you see a police officer. But I got news for you, God keep the police officer's eyes on somebody else if he know you're gonna do right to get that ticket paid.
Amen.
Oh yes, he will.
Yep.
Yes, he will. I got one of them stories too. On the road to Mississippi, didn't even know my license was suspended. Got stopped in the worst place in Oklahoma for speed. The officer said, now he could have just took me to jail and did one of those things. He said, did you know your license was suspended, sir? I said, no. But I was praying all the time. And he said, okay, sir, slow down. I'll let you go. And I said, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now I got to drive all the way to Mississippi, drive all the way back, and I know my license is suspended now. I didn't know on the way, but I know now. So now I got to trust the Lord even more. But he said he'll send thy angels to keep thy foot from dashing. See, once you know, now you know you got to slow down. You got to be cautious because you're in a troubled area.
Right.
But the officer was an angel to reveal to me that I'm running around in trouble.
All right.
To let me know something I didn't know. As my wife always said to me, she said, pay your tickets, pay your tickets. And I always, every time, I'll do it. Oh, you're always parking in the wrong place. You're always doing this. But see, that's an angel. That's God using her to be an angel to keep you out of trouble.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
You better be careful. Better be careful. I'm coming to the end here. He said, they. They is important in the 91st Psalm. God got a few angels for you. I can be assured that he's not going to leave me. Not only is he not going to leave me, but he got some extra help for me. Because I'm hard-headed. I'm a sheep. I'm hard-headed. I need a few people to tell me. Because when my wife tells me, I might not listen. When my husband tells me, I might not listen. God might place a few angels in my job, because sometimes we listen to the people at the job more than we do the people at home with us, the people that love us the most.
All right. All right. Amen.
But if I'm assured in Christ Jesus, I should be assured that God put her or him in my life. I need to pay attention. But just in case I don't, he got a few angels walking around.
Yeah.
Some folks you might not even know. God might That's send right. an angel down. You just met somebody at the store.
That's right.
They don't know nothing going on in your life. Mm-hmm. They ain't been in your house. They ain't been in your life. But they broke you down. Mm-hmm. They got you to do something you don't want to do most of the time. They got you to pick up a card or take something and put it in the car. Oh, they got you to back up a little bit. They got you to not be talking about. You ain't gonna say something. See, think about it. We don't say nothing mean to the people we don't know. We mean to the people we love. We more harmful to the people that are in Christ with us than we are to the people that need Christ.
Yeah.
You ain't gonna cuss nobody out in the street most of the time. But get in the house and let me push you to the corner. Let me back you up somewhere. Let me talk about you. Boy, don't you know what you're talking about? I'm your mom. Oh. Let me walk with you. Let me talk with you. Y'all don't know what I'm talking about, but then he got them angels. They shall bear thee up. Then he tells you, I'm strong in the power of his might. Because he says you will tread on what? I will tread upon a lion and an adder. The adder is one of the most venomous snakes in the world. Mm-hmm. He said, you will tread among them. That means I'm going to walk amongst the snakes. Donald Trump is nothing compared to an adder.
Mm-hmm.
Any of our elected officials, y'all can do what y'all want to. But if I walk right in the system that God gave me, which is honor thy master, he going to take care of me. I'm going to walk among them, and I'm not going to be worried. If you think you're beaten, you are. If you dare not, you don't. Start again against your beginnings. And never breathe a word about what you lost. That's part of a poem called If. Start again against your beginnings and never breathe a word about your loss. Okay, Lord, I had this, but I don't have it now. But I'm quite sure since you gave it to Job, that you'll give it to me. Mm-hmm. If you want me to have it.
That's right. That's right.
Wherever I am, it says, be content wherewith ye are.
Yes.
I'm going to be content wherewith I am because I know God is trying to take me somewhere. Mm-hmm. I'm assured without a shadow of doubt. That sometime, long time ago, there was a man that was brought in on a donkey, on the nastiest animal you can find sometime, but the king was brought in on a donkey. A misused and abused animal. But our king, our savior, was brought in on a donkey. And the same people that were going to kill him and talk about him 10 days or 7 or whatever days later was waving palms at him. How many people wave palms at you, but they don't mean you no good?
Yeah.
Oh, that's treading upon the lion and adder. You know why God is going to do all this? Because he promised. You know why I'm assured? Because those last three, 14, 15, and 16, are really because he said, if you love me, if you love me, what's he going to do for us? Because he has set his love upon me. I'm assured that I set my love upon him. That's why I'm always trying to outproduce, trying to be nice when I don't have it to be nice with. That's why I'm always trying to take care of, excuse me again, why I'm always trying to do the best I can for the wife that God gave me. Even when I shouldn't be doing it, I'm doing it anyway because that's what God does for us. He gives us stuff we don't need, don't deserve. He said, I promise you the desires of your heart. If you just love me. So if she tell me a desire, if I think she got a desire, I'm going to do my best to try and do it. That's because I'm assured that if I do right by God, God is going to take care of me. He's going to take care of me and mine. He's going to take care of my children. He's going to take care of my children's children. He's going to make a way and a pathway. He might need to send an angel to one of my grandkids right now because they're in trouble. But because I'm assured and assured in him, because I love him, he's going to send an angel to take care of them even though they're way in the wrong. Oh. And then again, something might happen. God will give me a way to provide for them. Okay. They got hurt. He lost a limb. But God is going to provide. Because he said, he promised. He said, because he has set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. Because he set his love on me, because I'm assured of the promise, I set my love on him, he said, I'm going to deliver you. He sent us the best deliverer we can, because when Jesus rode in on Palm Sunday some 2,000 some odd years ago, they didn't really know what was going to happen. But he rode in. He showed out when he went to the temple because he tried to put them out. Quit making my house, Father's house, a den of thieves. And then y'all tried to kill him. But he knew what he was doing. He was doing that for you and for me. He says, he shall call upon me and what? I will answer him. I hang my hat on it. If I call on him, he's going to answer me. He's going to give me an answer. I might not like the results, but he's going to give me the answer. And his answer is better than anything that the world can give me. Are you assured in Christ? Are you really assured in Christ? My assurance is my insurance. I hope you got that insurance that's above and beyond what I see, what I hear, what anybody tell me, my assurance is right here in this book. And if the 91 don't do it, he says, whom shall I be afraid? And he said, the Lord is my shepherd. I'm hanging 23. I'm hanging 27. I'm going to live and get buried in 91. Because I'm assured. Our assurance, your assurance, get one, hold on to it. It'll never sink you. Matter of fact, it might float you in the ocean. Now, how about a rock that'll float you in the ocean instead of sinking you in the ocean?
All right, now.
What kind of rock is that? That's a Jesus Christ rock.
All right, now.
That's a blessed assurance rock. That's my story. That's my song. When we sing that song, we ought to be able to sing it pulled deep down into your life, into what God has done for you. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Because in spite of what he knew I was going to do, they beat him, they whooped him, they hung him high, stretched him wide, put nails on him on that acacia wood cross. And then they thought they had him. But they didn't have him because he had to be our assurance. Come next Sunday, we can talk about Easter Sunday. Because it's a remnant that was left.
That's you and me that still believe that Jesus Christ is Lord of our life. That's you and me that still believe that the blood never loses its power. And because the blood never loses power, I don't have to accept things. I can love everybody, but I don't have to accept what you do.
That's right.
I'm going to love you. I don't like what you do, but I'm going to love you. Yeah. I'm going to treat you with love and kindness.
Yeah.
And because I do love you, I'm going to tell you it's wrong.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
I love my kids, so I'm going to tell you if it's wrong.
That's right.
It's up to you to do it. Last time I checked, Jesus was on the cross. Somebody talked about it, one of those hanging with him. But somebody was humble enough to say, be quiet. You don't know what you're talking about. He turned around and said, you'll be with me this day. So, last verse, 15, he said, he shall call upon me, I will be with him in trouble. I'll be with him in trouble. I will deliver him, and I will honor him because he loved me. That's God's promise to us. He promised. He said, I will honor him. Now, we're honoring God, but he's going to do something for us because we love him. Because we love him, he said, you call upon me and my name. If you call upon the name of Jesus, God is right there. He's going to answer. I'm assured that when they took him down from the cross, I'm assured that they thought they had it. I'm really assured of that because I know how man think. We all do. But one bright and Sunday morning, 3 days later,